Last week, I posted a video of my camp, and nearly every single comment was either asking me where I got certain plans or how I built so much with my camp budget. So I'm making this video to address both of those questions. Oh, and my camp finally got wiped, by the way, so I'm gonna be bitching about that for a second, too. Yay. For those of you who haven't seen it, here's my camp, or what used to be my camp before it was wiped by someone else's build. I'm okay. So I have unlocked all the walls and found plans for a good bit of workshop items, and this camp's budget is maxed out, by the way. I think I could place like one or two more items, but that's it. Now before I get into everything, I want to see what camp wiped out mine. I've had my camp in the same spot since the beta, so it feels like an end of an era, even though it's only been like a month and a half. And what is this? You know, it's so good that Bethesda added in where you have to have foundations before you can place anything else, because that way we don't have any hovering structures. Yeah, no hovering structures whatsoever. This makes so much sense to me. You know, I thought it was silly that we couldn't snap a floor to a foundation, but what do I know? This is structurally sound. And, well, you know, they actually did a pretty good job decorating this. I'm not shitting on this person's build, by the way. I'm just still bitter about some of these new limitations and the fact that my camp got wiped, but it's not their fault. But anyways, there are a couple things that you can do to find plans. The first thing is make your rounds to 4 or 5 different vendors. I do this every single day when I log in, so I'll show you my run. The first place I go is to Harper's Ferry. This is where you'll spawn in, and you'll need to head over to this hole in the wall. Yeah, I have the marsupial mutation, which is why I can jump like this. It's game-changing. I highly recommend it if you like, you know, jumping on stuff. If you follow this path I'm showing you, you won't encounter anybody you have to fight. You'll just hear them like I am now. But you want to make your way over to the Free States vendor bot right here, Vendor Bot Wallace. This bot has its own cap stash since it's a faction bot, so what I do is sell him as much as I can, and right now I have a ton of grenades, so I'll sell him enough grenades to wipe out his caps, and then I'll check out his inventory. And see, he's selling the brick and the barn building sets, which gives you the brick and the barn walls, but be careful here. There's a glitch where the barn building set will unlock conduits and not the barn walls. So a good way to tell is by looking at the prices. I have the hard bargain perk maxed out, so it might be a little bit cheaper for me, but you notice how the brick building set is 384 caps, while the barn building set is 192. This is how you can tell if it's going to glitch or not. The barn building set at 192 caps is going to unlock the conduits. If you see the barn set at 384 caps, then that's going to unlock the actual barn walls. So for those of you who are asking how I got the conduits, this is how. I thought I was getting barn walls, and instead I got conduits, which wasn't the worst thing, but still, you know, it's kind of annoying. And I haven't actually seen plans for conduits for sell or as drops anywhere, so I don't know what the hell's happening anymore. Alright, after I finish up with Vendorbot Wallace, the next stop is Watoga Shopping Plaza. I know I'm losing caps by fast traveling around, but you know, you gotta spend money to make money. When you spawn in, you want to go to this building to the right and find Vendorbot Phoenix. Yeah, this place is a nightmare. It takes a while to load and there's always robots shooting shit. But Phoenix has his own cap stash as well, so I do the same thing and sell him as much stuff as I can to wipe him out, and then I check out his inventory. Which he usually has a lot of cool stuff, like this is where I found the metal building sets, and like the TV, and the Edotronic. But these bots don't always sell this stuff, so if you don't see what you want, you can always wait until the next day refresh, or just server hop. Since there are always a bunch of enemies around here, I can't fast travel away. So what I normally do is run over to the vendor bot in this train station and wipe out his caps. Which does it for all of the train station bots since they share caps. And I'll check out their inventory too, but this guy normally doesn't have anything interesting. Now if I'm looking for plans, the last spot I'll go to is the White Spring Resort. If you've never been here before, I'd be kind of surprised, but once you spawn in, just go straight and go through these doors. And when you get inside, go down the stairs and to the right. You will find a bunch of different vendors, but the one that I go to is the Studio 58 vendor, which is all the way down here at the end of the hall. And all these vendors have their own cap stash as well, but they just share it amongst each other and not like the train stations. So I go through the same thing with him, wipe him out, sell him a bunch of shit, and then this guy always has the same stuff. I never really see anything changing here, but there are a lot of plans to choose from. Most of them are decor items, but if you want to find some cool stuff, come check this guy out, but he is very expensive. Oh, just a naked person running around. Hey, is this your bag? Oh, there's a bunch of plans in here. You don't need these? Because if not, I'm gonna take them. Alright. These are mine now. Hey, thanks for the plans! Look at this. Can't even look up from their pit boys. Hey, thanks. See, that's what's wrong with this generation. Damn millennials. So I do that same run every day and have found a lot of great plans from it. For me, it's the best way to find all the different types of building sets, but if you don't want to buy plans, another thing that you can do is complete quests at workshops. Each workshop will give you two quests back to back that always gives you some sort of plan once you complete them. The first quest is to simply kill all the surrounding enemies, then claim the workbench. As soon as you claim it, the quest will complete and give you some sort of workshop plan. A couple of minutes after you've claimed the workshop, another quest will pop up that requires you to defend it against waves of enemies. Normally, I'm not going to build anything at these workshops, so I'll just use all of its resources into building turrets to help with the quest. It doesn't really take that long, and as soon as you complete it, you will be awarded with some more goods and another set of plans. From what I can tell, these are random drops, but doing a lot of these back-to-back is pretty easy, and you'll get a lot of plans from it. And the last thing that you can do, other than just, you know, exploring and completing quests, you know, just playing the game, is join some sort of community. There is a subreddit that mainly focuses on trading goods in 76, and in my Discord server, I have a channel called The Trading Post. We use this all the time, where you can sell and trade and buy stuff on any platform. I've gotten a lot of plans that I was looking for from random people on here, and it's actually been a lot of fun working together like this. And no, I'm not using my YouTube channel to entice you all to join my Discord so I can bum plans off of you. That's definitely not what I'm doing right now. But the link's in the description. Now the last thing I want to talk about is the camp budget. A lot of people were asking me how I could build so much in my original camp that I showed earlier. And first off, I wasn't using any turrets. Turrets take up a huge chunk of your budget, and with this build, I didn't place any down so I could build more. So look at this. Watch the budget bar at the top. See, that one turret is taking up a huge amount for this build, and I have three of those placed down. And other objects like generators, conduits, and lights all take up a good bit of your budget too, so be careful when you're using those. Another thing is that I can confirm your budget increases with your level. I forgot that I made blueprints of my first camps, so I'm going to use these as references. This is the very first cabin that I made. I was level 5 when I made this, and this pretty much maxed out my budget. I remember because I made the blueprint when I couldn't really build anymore. There's a bunch of stuff in there like workbenches and things like that. And there's a radio on the table! Look at that! I'm not going nuts. Okay, so I built this during the beta, and I remembered having a radio in the menus, but when the game released, I couldn't find it anywhere. And I thought I was just going nuts, but I remember this now, because I opened up the shutters and it went through the radio, and I thought, okay, well, I gotta move that later. So we did have radios before, or maybe we still do, and I'm just blind and I can't see them. If they're in the menus, let me know, because I can't find them anywhere. Anyways, back to the cabin thing. This was level 5 cabin, and then I built this one at level 10, which didn't completely max me out, but it was pretty close. So the camp budget does increase with your level, but only if you place it down at that level. So if you place your camp down at level 5, the budget doesn't grow with you as you level up. You have to pick it up and place it down again in order for it to register. I don't know if this is true for everyone because of how buggy this game can be, but that's what happened to me. By the way, I tried to place down that blueprint to see if I could use the radio, like a regular workshop item, but of course the blueprint wouldn't place down anywhere, so who knows. But thanks for watching. I hope this video helped. If you guys have any more questions, please let me know in the comments. I will be doing a build video of my new camp in the next couple of days, so be on the lookout for that.